Hello. In the last sequence of lectures, we examined George Tooker's portraits of modernity, especially the cold, rational, calculating a climate that bureaucracies create. Traditional social groups, families, clans, tribes, continue to exist even in 21st century modernity. But these traditional groupings are today submerge underneath rational, logically organized, cold, modern bureaucracy. So what we want to do today is examine primary groups as the originary form of human group life and understand how primary groups construct and hold human beings, both physically and even more importantly with psychological identification, something that we're going to talk about in this slide series. Let's review briefly Charles Horton Cooley's distinction between primary and secondary groups. Primary groups are primary in the sense of being first in human development. They're the groups in which human beings emerge in intimate families. And they are also the kind of groups that the first human societies were composed of. They're primary in both of those senses. They're also primary in a third sense. Even in deeply bureaucratized late modernity, we still return as individuals day after day to the safe base of primary groups. That primary groups continue to be a source of emotional grounding and self-identity for individuals even today. Primary groups have the following characteristics. They're permanent, they're intimate, they're unplanned, they're informal. They are social groups with intensive and multi-sided interaction and strong emotional ties. The archetype of the primary group relationship is the tie between mother and child, mother and infant. And mothers and infants wind up with multi-sided bonding. Mothers literally touch infants on all sides of their being, and infants have often open access to mothers' bodies. There's a very close physical bond. With that bond goes tight emotional intimacy as well. All of the human emotions, from rage to giggling, are contained within the mother-child interaction. So this is what a primary group is. It is a group of human beings bonded together in a multiplicity of ways. High levels of emotion, high levels of identity in which the individual views the group as him or herself. Secondary groups have sort of the opposite set of characteristics as primary groups. They're impermanent, impersonal, planned, formal. Generally, they depend upon a contractual relationship, an actual formal contract. They're social groups that have mild, one-sided interaction. So if a primary group touched individuals on all sides, secondary groups have a tendency to touch only in limited ways, only in one side. And along with that one-sided tie is weak levels of emotion. That weak emotional transmission occurs within secondary groups.